Hi everyone. I wanted to take a moment to share a few tips with you guys. We have a lot of students that take our class that are just beginning to learn CSS, and one of the things that they're starting to learn in one of our assignments is how to underline text, and there's a couple different ways in HTML and CSS to do that. So I've kind of created a little bit of code in CodePen. If you're not familiar with CodePen, it just basically shows you the code you really need and not the extra HTML, even though behind the scenes it's still there. So just to show you a few little things, a lot of students by this point in the semester, they're starting to learn new styles and they've become familiar with what's called text decoration. Most commonly it's used with links. So text decoration gives you some various properties like underlining and overlining text. But one of the things students get frustrated with is they don't have a lot of control over that underline. So with that, I just wanted to show you guys an extra little tip for you guys. So obviously, if you just wanted to underline the text to be the same exact width, you can, style the color of your type, and then just basically the text decoration is going to be the same. I've commented out some text here for you guys. I'm going to go ahead and comment this so it hides this CSS, and I've got a little bit of extra stuff here for you to show you in just a second. So let me scroll down. So I'll uncomment the bottom code that I've kind of set up for you guys. And basically, this is an H1, similar to the assignment most of the students are doing. And I'm just going to comment out a couple lines real quick. So these little comments, you can either comment out one line or, as I did above, anytime you have the forward slash and the little asterisk and then closing it. That basically comments out a line of code. So I'm hiding the code basically in certain areas. So right here, this is not reading the width and padding right now, just because I want to show you what's happening. So with this H1, we've got the color, which has given it the style of the text. And then we've got a border property. And basically, the border property, we can control either the border on all sides, which is what's happening now. Or if we wanted to, we could control the top, the left, the right, or the bottom individually. So I'm just going to go through a couple different scenarios here. So I've set this up basically to control the width. So by default, if you don't have a width declared, it's going to take a 100% of your browser width. Okay, so that's what it's doing right now. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete that comment, and you'll see it changes it to the size that I've got here, which is 200 pixels. And then basically from there, one of the other things students get frustrated and want to be able to control is just things like the spacing right here next to the text. So if you need to add a little bit of extra spacing, you can add in padding. So padding basically gives the space between the element and the border. If you added margin, the space would actually go on the outside of the border. So that gives you a little bit of extra control over where that border is going. So now one of the things in one of the assignments is there's a border and it's just on the bottom. So there we go, we've got the border bottom. And we can actually change the size if we needed to be, 1, 2, 3 pixels, however large you needed. If you wanted a border on the top too, I mean, you could also do that. And then we can just kind of copy over those styles so that we've got the same thing. And then you've got a lot more control. So there's a lot of cool things that you can do with borders. And just know that a lot of the times, even though your mind might be thinking it's an underline, usually a lot of the times borders work a little bit more flexibly so you have more control over them. So I hope this helps you guys out. And hopefully this will help you with your assignment.